How do you play Monster Hunter Freedom Unite online? Well, kind of convoluted, but I can try to make it as simple as possible. Download PPSSPP, which is the PSP emulator we'll be using to run our game. You need to own the game, Monster Hunter Freedom Unite, and nope, I cannot give you the download link because that will get me in trouble. Though, make sure that the version you're gonna be using is the same as your friend's. After installing the emulator, go ahead and make a folder for your game and keep it nicely in there and make sure to remember what it is. Run the emulator and make sure to find where you place your game. Once you found it and reset the emulator, you will find it here in the recent games. You should be able to find it easily every single time you want to play. If there are some stuff you gotta change, go into game settings and change everything here yourself, from graphics to audio to anything that you think would be important for you. If your controller does not work, make sure to go ahead, open Steam, go ahead into Steam, go into settings, make sure to go to controller and click which controller you have while having your controller plugged in. It will force the emulator to recognize what you using. If this doesn't work, make sure to just add the game to your Steam and maybe that will work. By the way, I forgot to mention something. When you're downloading the emulator, make sure to download the portable edition. Do not download the installer, because the installer forces you to have your saves, textures and everything else in documents, and whenever you are going to be running into Windows issues or Linux, you're gonna have to delete your document folder to start all over again, and that means losing all your files. So make sure to use the portable edition. Do not use the setup. So once you get into the game, you might notice that it will look slightly not that great. You can change all these settings and more in the graphic settings, of course, but I will add a custom texture mod in case you want it to look from this to this. To be able to know exactly what game version you have, so you can find if this texture pack works or not, make sure to check up here where it says ULUS and see if it's the same version as the texture that you're playing with. If it is the same game version as well as the same texture, it will work. You gotta go ahead into your memstick folder, go into PSP, textures, and here is where you're gonna be dropping it. You're gonna drop it like this, like a folder with the name and the texture files right here. Then you're gonna go ahead into tools, developer tools, replace textures, and the textures will be working. Of course, you don't have to just use my texture pack, you can use whichever. There's many texture packs for this beautiful game. So if you don't like this, you can change it. You can also make the texture better or worse depending on how your graphic settings are set up. Once you think that the game looks fine for you to play it, and also your controls are working, make sure now to follow this next step to be able to play Monster Hunter FU online. Oh, one thing! Before going to online, remember to set up your fast forward button, because you will need it. You will need it for this farm especially. Surprisingly though, if you fast forward at the same time that your friend fast forwards and you are at the same FPS, you usually don't disconnect, so you can actually use this online and it will be fine. But don't spam it, because it actually can crash your connection. Have fun with this game though. There's many ways to play online. My way that I chose is a private way, which is using this program right here, Radmin VPN. The link is gonna be in the description, download it. This program is exactly like Hamachi. I'm gonna start it so you can see it. Make sure to click here to Radmin VPN, then make your own network, name it whatever you want, make whatever password, and then have your friend join. Once you two or three or whoever are in the server, copy the IP of whoever is going to be hosting the server, which is going to be whoever is going to be able to keep up their Radmin app for anyone to play whenever they want to. I'll copy my IP, for example. Go to the emulator, click game settings, more settings, networking, make sure to enable network WLAN, change your MAC address so it's not the same as your friend's. Otherwise, if you have the same MAC address as your friend, you will not be able to see them. Make sure to click enable built-in Pro AD HOC server and go ahead and paste your IP here where it says change Pro 8OC 8HOC server IP address, localhost multiple instances. You can also enable quick chat to be able to rapidly say something in chat in case you need to communicate with somebody as fast as possible. Once ready, you should be able to go over here to the online gathering hall. You press circle and you'll be able to connect yourself. Click whichever you want to play with your friend and you shall see them. Like I said before, if you don't see your friend here, make sure to change your MAC address to not have the same one as your friend, or try to see if they can host for you. There has been problems when which the emulator will be blocked by the firewall that you're using in Windows, so make sure to disable that or add this emulator in the excluded files of the firewall you're using, and it should allow you to host. This has been how to play Monster Hunter Freedom Unite online. I hope you enjoyed it, and make sure to let me know in the comments what else you want me to cover in the future. Like the video if it helped you out, subscribe to the channel of course, and I will see you the next time. Bye bye.